3, 2, 1. Trowel's down. That's it. Let's give him a nice hand. That was absolutely awesome. Got some big walls out there. I'm talking real big walls out there. They worked hard, but it's not done yet. They're going to get a couple of minute rest period. Then they're going to have an opportunity to take care of their wall. Ray, I want to talk to you. How you think you did? You got a high wall out there.
I believe I've done all right.
Done all right? Does that really take a lot out of you? You look pretty whipped.
A lot out of you.
Now, what's the highest you've ever done as far as putting stuff together like this for block? How many block?
122.
All right, well, good luck. I know you need a break. Go ahead. I need to get 4 minutes up on the Jumbotron, if you please. 4 minutes for a countdown. There we go. We got 4 minutes left. Gentlemen, go. It's time to start taking care of your walls. Go. The rest period is over. You've got 4 minutes left. And 45 seconds left, gentlemen and ladies. 2 minutes and 45 seconds left. I'll take your best shot. Is that all you got? I'll take your best shot. Is that all you got? I'll take your best shot. Is that all you got? I'll take your best shot. I'll take your best shot. I'll take your best shot. Is that all you got? About halfway through. We're about halfway through, gentlemen, so you know, halfway through. There's also judging requirements for the way they take care of their walls as well, and the judges are focusing on that to make sure it's done properly. They can only have one of the tools in their hand at a time that the judges know about, so. Less than a minute 30. This is an important time for them because there could be a lot of deductions involved that could take him from first, second, third, and actually knock them out of the prize fund. All right, we got about a minute left, about 1 minute. Got about 45 seconds left, so start finishing up your walls. I've got 30 seconds left. The clock up on the Jumbotron is a couple seconds off, and I will let you know when it's officially zero. Fifteen seconds left. The shadows come, but no one seems to care. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1-0. All tools down. Let's give all of our contestants a nice hand. Awesome job. Awesome job. In third place, from Riverside, California, Bob Christensen. Bob, come on up, buddy. Bob's team is Sean Romano and Gabino Barrera. In 1979, Bob joined the masonry industry and earned his contractor license, and he currently works for ASR Construction. And we just got done talking to Bob just a couple of seconds ago, who had a great idea about getting the kids off the couch and involved in a very respectable trade where there is nothing but integrity and an opportunity not only to make a great living, but to create some beautiful projects. Bob Christensen, come on down, Bob. As I said before, it was very, very close. You see, not all the walls are the different height, but remember, there are deductions that could take place. Guys, come on down here if you're the third place team. Come on, Bob, you and your team, come on down over here, because we're going to get a group picture at the very end of everybody. In second place today, from Gainesville, Florida, Ray Robinson and his crew. Nice job, guys. Lynette Darby and Jim Allen. We just got done talking to Lynette. Ray has worked for 25 years in the industry. He was the 2007 Fastest Trowel on the Block competition champion, and he placed second in 2008, 2009, and he gets a second again here in 2010. Some more cash for him and his crew. Congratulations. Nicely done. Let's give him a nice hand again.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Congratulations, guys. And before we give away our first place trophy as the fastest trowel on the block, they get a nice plaque and also $6,000. All our contestants work very hard today, the masons and the tenders, and hopefully we will see them back again next year. Our champion and title for the MCAA Fastest Trowel on the Block for 2010, in stall number 6, Chris Chi. From Maverick Masonry in El Mirage, Arizona, the tenders, Enrique Esparza and Gilberto Palacios. Let's give him a nice hand. Nice job, guys. Chris has worked in the masonry industry for 10 years. He won the 2008 Arizona Regional Fastest Trowel Competition and placed third in the 2009 National Fastest Trowel on the Block. And here he is taking home the nice trophy and $6,000. And a great honor, and I know we will see him back again next year, him and his team. Very nicely done. All of our masons and tenders out there worked very hard today. A big thank you to Quikrete. All of our sponsors, thank you so much. There is our champion now standing with our sponsors and our folks from MCAA. We're very grateful for everything. And without the support of the sponsors that you see all around the arena, we wouldn't be able to do an event like this. So hopefully we'll see you all again next year and root on your favorite team for the fastest trowel on the block.